This video is sponsored by Recall. I've been trying out a bunch of different note-taking and bookmarking services in preparation for my iPadOS 26 walkthrough. Now, this is a really big update, so it's been really important to me to make sure I am keeping all my research material in one place, whether it's links to stuff I find online, to stuff I discover in the beta so I can just, you know, jot down a note, or PDF documents that have lists of all the features. This is where Recall comes in. The best kind of short pitch I could give for what Recall is it's a bookmarking service meets note-taking app. In Recall, you can save links right into a database, but it's not just limited to articles. You can also save YouTube videos, podcasts, online PDFs, Google Docs, and even Google Slides. When saving any of these, Recall can generate two different kinds of summaries, a concise and a detailed version. I really like the concise summary because it kind of just gives me a overview of whatever that piece of content is about. And then if I want, I can go in and read the full article, watch the full YouTube video, or listen to the full podcast. Now, the ability to save links into Recall works especially great with YouTube videos and podcasts. You can pull out the key points and get kind of a better idea of what the content is about. But if you want even more detail, Recall will generate a full transcript under the Reader tab. You can also use the Chat tab to ask questions about what you saved. You can use this to get more detail about key points or just get a better understanding of what the link is about. I actually use this to help me figure out which Nintendo Switch 2 accessories I should get now and what I should kind of hold off for, you know, maybe see what's coming down the road. There is also a notebook section, so you can write down your own notes on what you have saved. This way you can expand on anything you have saved into Recall. In Recall, anything under the chat tab can be saved into the notebook section as well, whether it's a summary Recall generated or a question you asked about what you saved. When adding something to Recall, it will auto tag it for you. I found the auto tag system to be really good, but I went in and added a few more tags to a lot of the stuff I saved. Okay, so far I've just been focused on saving links into Recall, but there's different kinds of content you can save into Recall as well. You can upload local PDF documents. Just like with articles, Recall will make it searchable so you can ask questions or get a summary. You can also read the full document right inside Recall as well. With Recall, you can import all of your browser bookmarks, or even more important, import from Pocket. Pocket is unfortunately shutting down, so if you're using it as a read it later service right now, maybe check out Recall and import everything that's in Pocket over so you can kind of get a head start on that. I think Recall is a pretty great replacement for Pocket, especially with the auto tag feature, so it'll organize everything for you automatically. The last thing you can add in Recall is an empty note. Here you can write whatever you want, from meeting notes to a full document. I've even put my iPadOS 26 walkthrough outline in here. Another tab in the document section for Recall is Quiz. This will generate questions based on the item saved. This is the kind of thing I wish I had when I was a student. This would have helped me out so much. The graph shows all of your notes, links, and everything you've stored in Recall and how it is connected. Here you can see your main focus and how everything breaks out. Recall looks at what you've added and generates connections automatically so you can see how everything connects. Now, at the top level view of this, it looks a little crazy. But once you start to filter down, this is where things start to make sense and really becomes handy. Here I can see everything that I've saved that's connected to iPadOS 26. And at the center of it, my own iPadOS 26 walkthrough notes. With auto-generated connections, Recall will add a small note about what it is. But you can go into more detail if you wish. This can help with the research process, keeping track of contacts, or just fleshing out a project. Now, Recall has a Chrome extension, and this will just work with any browser that supports Chrome extensions. You can use this to quickly save links into Recall. You can also get a transcript of a YouTube video or a summary of a link right inside the extension. You can also use the chat feature right here as well. This will work with anything that's in your browser, whether it's a PDF document, YouTube video, podcasts, or whatever. The extension is a really powerful way of quickly saving links into Recall, but also giving you tools so you can access summaries and transcripts right from it. Another part of the browser extension is Augmented Browser. Now, this is something you need to go into the settings for the browser extension and turn on. Move your cursor over to this arrow to reveal it. From here, you can generate a summary from what is on the page, and you can also see all of the connections to the content you have saved to your Recall database. Now, what's really cool about the augmented browser is everything that's happening in this widget box right here is local. It's all on your device. It's not being sent to any servers. Stuff doesn't get sent to servers until you save it into your recall database. Now, recall isn't just limited to the browser. There is also an iOS and iPadOS app as well. And it has all the same functionality as the web app. For saving content to the app, you can use the Share Sheet extension. This will save content right into recall and will still auto tag it. I've mentioned in the past, I'm a big fan of Google's Notebook LM, but I think for me, recall beats Notebook LM. So a best example of this is even if you pay for Notebook LM, there is a limitation to how many files you can upload to it. With Recall, you can just go ham. You can upload as much as you want. I also vastly prefer Recall's organization features over Notebook's LM. Notebook LM is very manual, whereas Recall uses AI to kind of automatically sort and organize things for you, and plus adds those connections together. Plus, the browser extension makes it really easy to save anything from any web page. Recall can be a really powerful utility in anyone's hands. The ability to save links and have it generate connections can be extremely handy for research. Turning your saved notes into a quiz can be helpful for students prepping for a test. And the ability to transcribe videos makes this content actually searchable. Be sure to go check out Recall today. I have a special promo for all of you out there. You can use the promo code CL30 to save up to 30% off your subscription. Thank you all so much for watching and have a great day.